Martin, I see you didn't shave for us today, then.
No, but you didn't do your legs either.
I did them yesterday.
Well, anyway, man's fascination with flight has led him to find numerous ways of conquering the skies. With the Wright brothers giving us the power of flight and Icarus leading man's burning spirit of powerless flight, gliding has been a quiet but popular sport, but hasn't had the recognition that it truly deserves. This tranquil and beautiful sport can aspire people to greater heights within themselves and to enjoy the wonderful and scenic views around them. Gliding itself isn't as expensive as you'd think. With a gliding club in Larsham near Alton, it's a very rewarding and worthwhile sport to take up. Sanjay went there to see these quiet dragonflies of the world in flight with their intrepid pilots at the helm. That was a nice mellow documentary,
wasn't it? It was, yes. Put that away, slave. Stop reading his magazines.
Put that away as well, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't
know. I like that. I wouldn't mind getting as high as that myself.
I would, but not on aeroplanes. I must admit, I have vertigo, so yes, I'd have to get high in other ways, really.
Well, we would definitely discuss that in front of the studio. I think now we'll go over to the news and weather, shall
yes,
we?
Yes, I think we've got the news and weather after we've mellowed out on that piece.
It's going to be Jo Tunicliffe with the news and the weather.
off.
Good afternoon and welcome to the 1 o'clock Genesis lunchtime news. I'm Jo Tunicliffe. Bruce Grobbelaar, the footballer at the centre of the match with the allegations, is expected to return to training with his Southampton teammates this morning. He was released by police yesterday after being questioned for 34 hours. Aston Villa's John Fashanu and the Wimbledon goalkeeper, Hans Sager, were also released along with Mr. Fashanu's girlfriend and the Malaysian businessman. They're all on police bail while the inquiry continues.
After more than 30 hours in police custody, goalkeeper Bruce Grobbelaar joked it was a pity he hadn't been released in time for his club's latest match, but he was clearly relieved to be free.
I hope to be back in training and to be selected for the weekend, because we've got a very important game on the weekend, and I hope to be in the squad.
Bruce has always strenuously denied the allegations that first appeared in the Sun newspaper in November of last year. He maintains that denial now, as emphatically as he has ever done.
It was a rather different Grobbelaar to the man who'd been arrested in an early morning swoop on his New Forest home the day before. Detectives have dismissed speculation that they plan to arrest more players. They do say it's likely they'll want to question others, but only as potential witnesses.
Researchers have discovered that an average of one person per month is killed by designer drugs bought in fashionable nightclubs. The use of ecstasy has reached epic proportions amongst Britain's ravers. Experts from across Europe will tell a major conference in Manchester today that a more enlightened approach to the problem is needed to prevent more teenagers being killed.
A decade ago, alcohol would have fueled the night out for these clubbers in Manchester. Today, it's more likely to be the drug ecstasy, an appetite suppressant, which is now being blamed for one death every month.
Some people take alcohol to get them out of a bad mood. If they're taking ecstasy, that's 3 hours of a good time.
Among those attending today's conference are experts from Holland. They test drugs in their clubs to make sure they're pure.
And it doesn't come into it. We don't need to encourage these people anymore. What we do need to do is provide them with accurate and up-to-date information that will help reduce the harms.
The one certainty is that drug abuse is on the increase, and statistically, by the end of this month, another teenager will be dead.
Teachers are to launch a campaign today to highlight the appalling state of some of the country's school buildings. Details of a survey they made in England and Wales will be revealed this afternoon. It is expected to show that hundreds of schools are in a dangerous state of disrepair.
This school has been through the wars, literally. These timber buildings were once a field hospital in France during World War I. The school records show they were put up as temporary accommodation in 1929, but today they still house some of Parkdale Primary's 400 children. The crumbling buildings and cramped conditions have caused numerous problems for staff. Today's survey is expected to show that Parkdale is not very unusual. Over half the schools in the land have problems with roofs and ceilings. Others have rats and unhygienic conditions. At Parkdale, the head is not optimistic that things will get better, but he says his staff will battle on, fitting pupils into every habitable nook and cranny.
The student car park at Farnborough College of Technology is a constant problem for drivers to the college. There often appears to be no spaces in which to park, but most frustrating is the surface and the huge potholes which can't be avoided. So is it not time something was done about it?
This is a common sight in the student car park, a problem which can only add to the high cost of maintenance involved in running a car. It seems the college are aware of the problem, but are they prepared to do anything about it?
Well, we are considering resurfacing it at the moment. As you probably know, we have considered that in the past. We approached the local council with our intention to resurface it some years ago now, and they indicated that they were pleased that this was going to happen, but also indicated that they wanted it to be properly drained. When we investigated what properly drained meant, it meant that they were talking about rather a larger sum of money than we had in mind, so we decided to shelve it at that stage.
We went to Rushmore Borough Council to find out what drainage was needed and the estimated cost. Lance Cooper, Principal Drainage Engineer, told me what was involved.
Right, the current system allows water falling onto the surface to pond within the car park and then dissipate and soak into the ground over a period of time. If you were to put an impervious surface on the car park, you would need to put some formal drainage in. That could either be an off-site sewer, or you could actually construct soakaways within the car park that took water into them and soaked directly into the ground.
What costs are likely to be involved in this?
Both systems would work out similar types of costs. They would be in the region of £30,000 for either. You may actually achieve something slightly cheaper than that with a soakaway system.
Although this seems like a lot of money, I asked the highway section what the total cost of resurfacing the car park. They said the total cost would be in the region of £270,000, so an extra £30,000 is neither here nor there. But it seems that nothing's going to happen during our college life. This is Gary Coombs, Genesis News.
Southampton Football Club hope to have Bruce Grobbelaar back in action this weekend after his release on bail following 34 hours of questioning over match-fixing allegations. Dave Besant took his place in goal last night as Southampton drew 1-1 with West Ham at the Dell.
The eyes of the Far East were on the Dell, but the only thing worth betting on was that they wouldn't get in. The house full signs were up, and while a mile away, Bruce Grobbelaar was negotiating his release from custody, custody of the Southampton goal had been handed to Dave Besant. Reserve keeper or not, though, Dave Besant soon won over the critics with a string of fine saves. There wasn't much he could do about Don Hutchison's header that gave West Ham the lead. But that apart, Besant proves he will take his chances while Bruce is away.
Farnborough College rugby team were in action yesterday by hammering Luton University 19-3 in a friendly in order shot. Farnborough go on now to look forward to the Chiswick Sevens tournament on Wednesday.
Farnborough College playing in the blue shirt played Luton University yesterday and comfortably were outright winners by beating them 19-3. Farnborough played an attacking game which had their opponents against the ball throughout the 80 minutes match in which the dominating team scored three exciting tries. The first came in the first half by fullback Rich Puzzleway, which was created with a great move by the whole team. Captain Andy West had every reason to be pleased with his team's performance because the determination and character within the team have dominated throughout the season, and subsequently the team finished third in the league. The team now look forward to the forthcoming seventh tournament at Chiswick with great hope.
I think the lads did well today. They came out, they haven't played together for a couple of weeks, and I think the boys really did well today there. They've come together today well. I'm really impressed. I think from here we can start up again and perhaps go to Chiswick Sevens next week and hope for a good win there.
That's the news. I'm Jo Tunicliffe, and after the break we go over to Robin Young or Johanson for the weather. Thank you.
Hello. Well, it's certainly been a week of changeable weather. We've seen rain, we've seen sun, sleet and even snow. After a bright start in central England and Wales, rain will spread east across all areas during the afternoon and evening. This rain should turn more showery, whereas in the south, if anything, it's going to be more cloudy and we should expect rain in the evening. Northern Ireland will be cloudy with rain, and in northern England there will be lots of snow over the hills. Still blizzard conditions over the Scottish mountains, blown in by those strong winds up in the north there, bringing in snow and rain. And those winds are going to be making us feel rather cold. Temperatures looking about 5 and 6 up in the north, 8 or 9 down here in the south. This low pressure up here will be with us through Friday, bringing us a rather disrupted weather, bringing sort of breaks in rain, in snow, and in most southern counties there'll be lots of rain too. Otherwise, the wintry showers and the cold westerly winds will continue, as indeed they will probably be into the weekend as well. For most of Europe too, it's the unsettled mixture with this deep area of low pressure off the coast of Norway, you know, dominating most of the weather as we've seen it over the past week. If you're off to a holiday resort in Spain or Portugal over the weekend, you can be sure to enjoy a good deal of sunshine, as this anti-cyclone will affect the weather over the Mediterranean, putting the temperatures up into the 25 range. That's the indifferent look of the weather this week. That's all from me. Goodbye.
We are going to have an orgasm that you can't even comprehend.
Genesis. Welcome back. I hope you enjoyed that part of Genesis. Now, if you really enjoyed platforms, flares, and even weirder hairdos, then we've got a surprise for you. Because if you enjoyed watching Shoestring and The Protectors, then Genesis's own team have been out and made their own 70s classic drama, swinging their flares for The Protractors. We now go to the first episode of The Protractors.
I wanted to see you. Three targets. As individuals, they pose no threat. But as part of the Protractors Foundation, they threaten to destroy me. Danny Rule, Jason Sinclair, and the Countess de Cappuccino.
But we haven't given you your present.
We chose it personally.
Oh, Danny, Jason, it's lovely. Mwah. Mwah.
Goodness gracious.
Look, he's getting away.
Curious.
It matches the one that was found in my husband's hand the day he was murdered.
Then you were the target.
For your own safety, Countess, I think you should remain in hiding. Myself and Jason, we're going to see an old acquaintance of mine who may be able to give us a lead.
Sake, Jack.
Curie, why don't you go powder your nose, eh? Danny Rule, the last time I saw you, after police in Paris were looking for the Monaco diamonds.
I'm in a new line of business.
Who's the groover?
Jason Sinclair.
Someone's got a contract out on one of my friends. What's the word on the street, Jack?
It just so happens that I did hear some goons talking the other day. And if your friend happens to be the Countess de Cappuccino, then I'm afraid she could be in extreme danger.
So I'll have my usual case of Dom Perignon, the Countess de Cappuccino. Cancel that order.
Cover me!
Welcome back. I hope you enjoyed that. It was most amusing. What did you think of that then, Martin?
Very nice. I just hope that guy with the curly hair, the really good-looking one, is okay.
God, he's tremendous. I'm sure he will be, though.
Was that one of your cousins or something in that show?
Yes, we have similar moustaches, as you can see. Mm. Yes. It's, we could go on all day talking about the Protractors, but we're not. We're going to go live to you in the refectory. We'll have a sneaky look at what you're up to.
Have a look.
People are actually watching us. Oh, there's not many.
Oh, look, there's a lot of people down there.
Oh,
hi, down there in the refectory.
Hello, what are you up to? All eating
Let's
your
have
lunch?
Look, who have we got down there?
Oh, there's a few bobs.
Oh, there's that Kirk.
Who's that?
Hey, look at him. He's all shite on camera.
Oh, I don't know. Oh, somebody feeding their face there. Yep. You're all enjoying yourself, I can see.
Can we just have hands raised those down there if you're actually enjoying what we're doing here?
Oh, yeah, we've got a great response.
Like, now? Oh, great.
Oh, that's right. Carry on fanning me. I need
this.
Yeah,
please. Getting warm.
Getting steamy in here. Well, I hope you're enjoying it in the refectory there, over your cheese and pickle sandwiches. Just remember, we have got a lovely selection of food in the canteen.
And next Tuesday, Seb Fontaine at the SU. Good one to watch. But now we're going to go...
There's some more commercials, I think.
Yes, more commercials is great.
No money. Over 19. Want some money. Bad luck.
Do you have problems with overcrowding in the computer room?
Well, just a minute.
Frustrated you can never get on. Don't you just hate it when that happens? If you use the time effectively, you can find no problems with overcrowding. Between 9 and 10:30 every morning, the computer room is relatively empty.
So assignments can be handed in on time.
Welcome to the bookshop! We've got crazy prices! We've got books coming out of our ears! Blue tack, 80p! Pencil sharpeners, 15p! Outline pens, £1.25! 65p of Camerine Throat! Pencils, 20p! Oh, bonkers! Come on down to the bookshop! It's a mind-blowing experience!
Still want some money? No grant? Then why don't you apply for the Student Access Fund? Simply go to reception and someone will speak to you about it.
Eggs, beans, chips, sausages, curries, pizza, sandwiches, vegetables, butter, salads, cakes, biscuits, juice, tea, coffee, milk, or
Cheese and pickle sandwich.
Don't be an anorak. Use a refectory.